Hello and welcome back to the Great Men Do Exist video series. I'm here today with Matthew Coast. Matthew, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks so much for being here with us. Really appreciate you coming on the video series here. Matthew helps strong, independent women attract quality men into committed, lasting relationships. He's reached over 3 million women with his advice and has been featured on dozens of podcasts, blogs, and summits over the last 11 years. He's helped women fix their marriages, find their soulmates, and get into committed relationships even when things have seemed hopeless. Well, that's just awesome, Matt.
It's exciting. It really is. I love doing this work. I love, you know, helping people. Mm-hmm. I love when I get success stories from women who, you know, felt like they, like everything was just falling apart, like they're giving up on men, like they're giving up on dating, like they're giving up on relationships, you know, and having them go and meet a guy that they feel is their, you know, soulmate, their Mr. Right, and getting into a great relationship. I love everything about it.
Yeah, you know, actually, I'll share a little bit. When I first began my love journey years ago, I felt exactly that way. I felt completely hopeless, like everything else in my life was fantastic, and that was the one thing holding me up. So I can definitely appreciate, you know, that hopeless feeling and getting over it. So if it's okay, I'll just jump right into some of the questions we have.
Yeah, go ahead, ask away.
Awesome. So one of the things you talk about is how blocks tend to, like, you know, emotional blocks tend to hold women back from love. So what are some typical blocks that you might have that would prevent you from finding love out there?
Yeah. So back before I was a women's dating coach, I was actually a men's dating coach for a number of years. And I worked with tens of thousands of men. And one of the big things that we used to do is we'd go out to bars, you know, with these guys, and they'd, you know, want to meet women there. And so I would hire or, you know, just bring out some women who would, like, kind of act like the wing woman, you know. She would come out and, you know, be the, make it easier for a lot of these guys to go and talk to women. And, you know, it's interesting. I had this one woman that was, working for me like that for a while. And it was really interesting because she would always complain to me that guys never hit on her. You know, guys never flirt on me. Guys never hit on me. And she was an attractive girl, you know? And so I'm like, you know, I'm a little skeptical, you know,
yeah.
And I'm like
really?
I don't think that's true. I just, you know, it's possible. I just don't think it's true, you know? And so I was like, okay, let's go to this, you know, place and we'll go and check it out. And so, we went to this club. It was down here in Denver where I live. And it was one of those clubs where it's like a long line that goes all the way to the back, you know? And so I marched straight to the back, you know, cause I'm like, that's the best way to find out what happens, you know, in this situation. So I marched straight to the back and, you know, on the way back there, she's getting hit on by like every guy in the entire place, right? Like every guy in the place is like, you know, coming up to her and dancing and be like, hey girl, you know, or like coming up and trying to talk to her. And she's like, get away from me. Screw you. You know? We get to the other side of the bar and I'm like, I looked at her and I was like, I thought you said that guys never hit on you. Like, what's going on? And she's like, they don't. And I'm like, oh, I see. You know, she had no idea that guys were hitting on her this entire time, you know, because she reinterpreted it, right? So
yeah.
One of the things about blocks, there's a thing that I have that I call the goddess formula. And there's three parts.
That's a nice ring to it.
yeah, it's great. Great. And it's really, whenever I talk to women, whenever I have any kind of coaching situation, And I figure out what's going on with them, it's usually one of these three things that's out, right? And the one that we're talking about right now is the belief system, right? Your belief system. And what happens is if you have a belief system that says that guys don't hit on you for whatever reason, you know, maybe it's a belief system that says that you're unattractive or that, you know, you're not relationship or commitment material or that guys are, you know, whatever, you know, just, they're not interested in you like that. You know, what's going to happen is you're going to go out and you're going to experience that in the world, regardless of what reality is, you know? And so a lot of us men have this too. Everybody's got this, right? We have these subconscious things going on that we have no idea. We have no idea that it's preventing us from experiencing the lives that we want to have. It's preventing us from having the relationships, from earning the amount of money that we want, from having, you know, the physical fitness levels that we want to have. We have all these, you know, internal turmoil, these beliefs that sabotage our ability to create success in our lives. And so, you know, there's a lot of those. You know, one of them is, you know, believing that like all men are like liars or pigs, or they don't, believing that men don't want commitment. It's funny. Sometimes I go out to bars to talk to, like, I'll go to like young women's professional meetings and stuff like that. It's always entertaining. You know, and I'll come in there.
Wait, why is it entertaining?
Well, because so I'll walk in there and I'll you know, and I'll start talking to some women, you know, and I'll tell them that I'm a women's dating coach. Mm-hmm. And whenever I say that, I always get this. They always it's like the mood like shifts, right? They like look at me and they're like, "You're working with the wrong people. It's men that are the problem, not us women. It's men. Men are the problem, right?" And yeah. And like that's a problem, you know. Like if you come, like, imagine you go and meet a guy, right? And it doesn't matter what he says, even if he says like the most amazing things to you, if you start to like notice, like your beliefs come through your communication, regardless of whether you want it to or not, right? Mm-hmm. And if you believe that men are pigs, sorry, what was that?
Subconsciously.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Subconsciously. Mm-hmm. You know, and as a woman, you know, most women are gifted with this power of intuition, right? And as a woman, you know, you might sense it from a guy, right? If a guy thinks that women are the problem, right? Mm-hmm. Or if a guy thinks that women are all liars and women are all cheaters, you know, which is the same problem in the men's dating side as well. Right. You're going to feel that, and you're going to be like, oh, there's something that I don't like about this. There's something I don't like about this. It's a big red flag. And if you have any respect for yourself, you'll get out of that situation and you won't get into a relationship with that guy. And that's something that happens with guys too. You know, if a guy's talking to you and he senses that you don't like men, or that you want to change men, or you think that men are bad, or, you know, that whatever, you know, if you think men are liars and cheaters, if, you know, there's all kinds of things. If you have lots of insecurities about things that have, you know, gone on in your past and you haven't dealt with that stuff, that mm-hmm. all comes out in your communication. And it, for a man, it's not attractive at all. And in many cases, it can repel them and push them away.
Right. And I love that you mentioned that, because if you are attracting men and accepting them, you're probably attracting the wrong ones, right? And ignoring the ones that are good for you because of where your mindset is at, you know? So you're even if you are attracting in a high quality man, you won't be able to keep him for very long.
Right, because they'll figure it out, you know, and not only will they figure it out, but your belief systems, those blocks that we're talking about right now, will start coming up for you, and you'll start seeing them. The most amazing, perfect guy for you in the entire world could show up at your doorstep tomorrow and, you know, just say all the right things and do all the right things. But if you don't have it together, you know,
I'm envisioning women thinking like, oh, wouldn't that be great?
Just like, mean, it would be great. It would be great. Ding dong. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you know, it doesn't matter. I was actually, I was dating this woman a few years back. And I had just come out of this like transformational workshop thing. And I was all like just super pumped about authenticity and honesty. And I just, you know, like I came to her and I was like, I was living in Tempe, Arizona at the time. And we're walking down Tempe Town Lake and just having a little romantic stroll at night. And you know, I was telling her about the type of relationship that I wanted and the, you know, what I wanted to create and like, you know, all the things like, you know, that I wanted it to be like. And you know, she was just like, she's like, oh, that's so amazing. That's perfect. That's exactly what I want too. You know, and then, you know, I left and the next day I called her and literally overnight, I don't know what happened. But, well, I do know what happened. Her, you know, beliefs started kicking in and she was like, I don't believe that what you're talking about is real. You know, I think you're just trying to mess with me, you know, and all these things started coming out of her mouth. I'm like, what are you talking about?
What's going on?
And it was like the relationship was like from there. Cause it was, you know, it wasn't going to work like that. You know, she didn't believe it. She, you know, and she started pulling away. You know, a lot of women don't like it when guys pull away. Well, women pull away too. All the time.
So she was not trusting you or herself.
Yeah. She didn't. Yeah. I mean, her belief system, her way of looking at the world, basically told her that what was going on right there was not only not possible, but that it was, you know, some kind of trick and that, you know, maybe she couldn't have it or it's too good to be true or, whatever. And, that happens to all of us, all the time, you know, without us even knowing it. And then we're like, oh no, he was bad. And, you know, and we start rationalizing it in our mind because that's what we do. And, yeah.
Yeah. So as far as the blocks are concerned, you know, going to the next question here, cause it relates back to what we were just talking about. When are we most likely to like acquire these? You're seeing all the time, which, you know, I believe is true. I also believe that, you know, at a young age, we're really impressionable. Right. Mm-hmm. So how, you know, when and how are we likely to acquire these beliefs and like, how can we work with that?
Yeah. So, so as far as acquiring them, it's like, so when I was, when I grew up driving a truck, right? And I, you know, drove a truck a lot in my life. I joined the military, bought an SUV, went to Iraq, drove up armored SUVs there and stuff. And I came back from the military and I, went out and bought a Honda Civic. And, you know, when I was in a truck, it was like, you know, I'm like climbing over things, you know, I'm just hitting stuff. I'm like, yeah. Oh, it's a truck. Doesn't matter. You know,
having a little bit more fun there.
Yeah. I'm going over curves. Doesn't matter. You know, all of a sudden I'm in a Honda Civic and I'm like bottoming it out. I'm like putting big dents in it. It's way more difficult to, climb over a curb in a Honda Civic than it is in a big SUV, just in case you guys wanted to know that. And it's the same. So the way, so what I had to do was I had to relearn how to drive and I had to relearn how to drive this car. Because that's the situation that I was in then. And it's kind of the same way in our lives. You know, we develop thoughts, you know, I believe that when we're born, we are born with the ability to attract the opposite sex into our lives in an amazing way. And then we're born, you know, and we start experiencing life and we start having emotional trauma. We start making meaning out of things. We start learning things from our parents. We're learning things from society. We're learning things from school. We're learning things from, you know, the experiences that we have. And, you know, if you grow up and you feel like you're all alone, right? You feel like your, you know, parents abandoned you or you feel, you know, whatever, and you have to develop a new way of being. So let's say, you know, you did feel like you were alone growing up and you develop this strong outer shell where you're pushing people away because, you know, you're afraid of them to get close because you know that you feel like they're going to leave you again. Yeah. You know, you will end up taking that into relationships when you become an adult. And so you have to relearn how to come to a relationship if you have those things. And pretty much everybody has them. Pretty much everybody I've ever met in my entire life has been broken up. Pretty much everybody I've ever met has, you know, some type of emotional trauma and baggage. And so, you know, the absolute best way is through coaching. Right. And there's a whole bunch of other things as well. But the best way is getting in some kind of live environment because, you know, we were talking about like rationalizing things earlier. Well, we have an ego, right? We have this kind of way that our mind is. And it feels threatened when it starts getting challenged. So it's really difficult to change those beliefs and those insecurities and those things by ourselves, because we live in a bubble. And if that gets challenged, we can jump back into the bubble and be like, nope, I'm here, don't want to deal with that. You know, and we start rationalizing it. No, that's really the way things are in the real world. That's how things are, you know? And if we go into a coaching environment, whether it's like a seminar, whether it's group coaching, whether it's one-on-one, we're held accountable, right? Mm-hmm. And so they might start saying, hey, you know, men really aren't pigs, you know, like men aren't, you know, trying to screw you over. And you'll be like, no, they are. And you're like, well, let's think about this for a minute, you know, and you can talk through it, and they'll help you figure out what it is that happened in your past so that you can heal from it. You know, there's, yeah, all kinds of stuff like that. And so that's the best way. That's the best way.
I agree. Cause, coaching is what changed my life. And then I just, you know, soaked up all these different, you know, trainings and information like a sponge and got trained myself. But when I first began training, I very much thought the same way. It's very challenging. But mindset is everything, you know, and your ego has, you know, built up all of this information over time. And it's thoroughly convinced that avoiding certain things is going to keep you safe. And what it really prevents you from doing is living your life. You know, I believe, like you said, when you're born, you have this ability to be magnetic, and it's because we're born as love, which is what we really are at our core, is love, I believe. And so all of these experiences that we have, some of them are positive, many of them are negative. And you know, unfortunately, it's like relearning the good stuff, you know, so it's really strong, and unlearning all of the crappy stuff, you know, that we've learned over time. And so it's work, but it makes life a whole lot more fun.
Well, it makes everything
just
better.
Just like the SUV.
Everything better. Everything in your life will be better. I 100% guarantee it. You'll be more successful in whatever business venture you're in. Mm-hmm. You'll figure out more, you know, better ways to be healthier. You'll be happier. You'll, you know, live a more fulfilled life. People, you'll start attracting more people just in general. Everybody will be attracted to you when you like let go of things and just, you know, really embrace what is. And it's really, really powerful. And to a guy, you know, when you're talking to a guy, that kind of thing, you know, there's kind of this talk out there and the dating space about mystery, right? Creating a mystery about mm-hmm. yourself, or being mysterious or whatever, you know, being mysterious is attractive, you know, as a technique where you're, you know, trying to like manipulate a guy by being mysterious, that can backfire in your face. But if, you know, there's a part of women that are mysterious anyway, right? And it's this, you know, emotional, nurturing, you know, even just somebody who's, you know, accepting and loving, you know, it's most guys rarely experience that. I mean, they don't experience that at all. And so when a guy does meet a woman and she's done some work and she's like, you know, I accept you, I accept me, I accept the world, you know, I'm living my life, I love it. You know, it's like, who are you? You know, like,
where did you come from?
How did you, yeah, like, what's going on? What's going on here? You know,
and it's, joke, yeah.
It's great. It's beautiful. It's attractive. It's irresistible. You know, it's amazing.
Very cool. And I'm a big fan of being vulnerability. I believe it creates connection. And I love what you said about letting things go and letting things happen, because I think what a lot of people don't realize is that when they are closed off on purpose to the bad things, they're also closed off completely to all of the good things. You know, life is going to happen. And if you're closing off to one part, you're closing off to all of it.
Absolutely. That is absolutely true.
I mean,
you gotta like, my suggestion, and it's scary, it's a very scary thing, you know, to talk about this stuff, because somebody actually, you know, if you go around the world and you're not vulnerable, you're not taking any risk, right? Because you know that, you know, if somebody rejects you, it's like, well, you know, they didn't really even know me, you know. But if you get real and you get vulnerable, mm-hmm. and, you know, then rejection seems a lot scarier, you know, whereas, but it's the only way, that you can have something because then when you're vulnerable, that's when somebody can actually love you for who you are. Mm-hmm. Whereas, you know, if you just go out there and learn a bunch of techniques and tactics, it's like, well, those techniques and tactics didn't work, you know.
Yeah. Techniques and tactics are great initially, but they don't work to sustain long-lasting love. Like, you might be able to attract somebody great, but keeping them is a different story, and we definitely want to keep them.
So, yeah, no, you are, you know, it's funny that you are exactly right. Mm-hmm. You are exactly right. And I'm a big fan of kind of a holistic outlook on this. And, you know, there's a component to that, which is communication, right? Mm-hmm. And this communication component is, you know, things like, what are you going to say? You know, how are you going to act? You know, what's your body language? How are you dressing? You know, all that kind of stuff. And that stuff is very important, you know. Mm-hmm. But if you focus only on that, which is what most people want to focus on, it's just that, like, I can't tell you how many, you know, women come to me and they're like, just tell me what to say, you know? And I'm like, I'm
just
like,
give me a line.
Yeah. And I'm like, well, I will do that. But also, I need to help you, you know, with the internal stuff, because if I don't, mm-hmm. then it's not going to last.
Right. You know? Then all that work will be for nothing.
Exactly.
So important. Well, I'd love to ask you too, cause you do mention it a bit on your site. How have your experiences, your personal experiences, informed your, you know, point of view on the topic? Is there anything you'd like to share at this
point? Personal experiences.
Yeah,
you know, I came from a broken home. You know, I grew up in a family. Both my parents have been married 3 times, mm-hmm. you know, like neither one of them have experienced a particularly good relationship in their lives. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like there's been a lot of that kind of stuff in my family and in my life. And really, you know, this whole thing for me is about helping to change that and helping to transform that. Mm-hmm. Right. And, you know, I don't want kids to grow up with single moms anymore. Yeah. I mean, it's painful. Yeah. It's painful for everybody. You know, I believe that there's a better way for men and women to connect with each other, you know, mm-hmm. and we're in a new age, an age where, where men and women don't need each other anymore. We don't have to, we aren't, you know, pressured into relationships like we used to be. Women don't have to rely on a man to support them anymore. Mm-hmm. And so in order to be in a great relationship, in order to attract a great person into your life, you have to be a great person. You know, it's not forced anymore. And so if you want to, you know, and hopefully it's the same with, it's the same with you, you know, meeting a guy. Hopefully the guy, you know, you aren't accepting men into your life who aren't great men. You know, it's a two-way street. You know, we're learning how to be better people and be in relationships better because we want something that's amazing and that lasts. Because, you know, a lot of old people that are kind of in the generation that's kind of dying right now.
Yeah.
That I know.
The World War II type. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, they stayed together even if they hated each other.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, mm-hmm. they would stay. It didn't matter. They stayed.
Yeah. Commitment was commitment. That was it.
Yeah. Now it's like you can get married at a drive-through, you know, get a Big Mac with your marriage, you know, and divorcing is just as easy, you mm-hmm. know? And so, in an age where we aren't forced to stay together, it's like, how do we, you know, and it's something that we all want. How yeah. do we create this experience where we want to stay with each other, you know? And absolutely. that's what this is all about. And that's why I'm doing this, is because I want change to happen.
Absolutely. And I totally agree. And I love that you just brought up, you know, kind of two really contrasting examples here, right? Because you're talking about the folks from, you know, like, from the World War II generation versus, like, you know, our parents' generation, right? And that's interesting because the divorce rates are so much different. people were still like happy, not happy, maybe at the same rates. You know, people were just determined to be in a failing relationship. But I feel like our generation, because we've seen so much divorce, is really delving into personal relationships a lot more. You know, we're really wanting to understand. And I think that's, you know, a positive result of all everything, unfortunately, that's gone on with the divorce rates and whatnot, because it's forced our generation to look deeper into this and to heal it, right? So that hopefully this generation and the next has learned something that we can apply and have really a lot more successful results in that area.
Yeah, I mean, if nothing else, at least our children and grandchildren are going to be in a much right? better situation.
Yeah. Than we are. Yeah. That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for sharing that story. Let's see. I'm going to ask you, I think, one more question. Yeah. So going back to the blocks a little bit, what would you say to women who have blocks but are not, you know, sure what those are yet or what to do? I mean, we mentioned coaching, but maybe someone who is like skeptical about coaching, where would one start? Because there's a lot of folks out there who love the idea, but they don't think they can afford it, not sure if it's the right fit for them with their time. I mean, what would you say to that objection?
If I were you and you feel like that might be what's going on, one thing that you can do is you can get programs, right? And programs will talk about different things, and when you're going through a program, and what you want to pay attention to when you buy a program is that it has all like multiple components. It's not just about words. It's also about, the beliefs and thought processes and stuff. And just look at some of those beliefs that people talk about in those programs and say, how do I feel about this? Right. And if you feel a lot of resistance for some of those beliefs, that's a good indication that you need some coaching. Yeah. It's a good indication. And there's also a lot of, there's a lot of coaches out there who do like free, who'll do like a free consultation with you. And they, a lot of times they will tell you exactly what's going on with you, and they are experts at breaking it down and figuring it out and saying, hey, this is what's going on, and usually what happens there is they'll say, okay, we've had our consultation. This is what's going on for you. This is what you need to do. You can go and do it by yourself, or you can get coaching and do it with me. Yeah. And you're usually you're never under any obligation to sign up for anything if you do a free consultation with any of these coaches. And they'll give you some valuable information that you can apply into your life, immediately, typically. So,
you can go, oh yeah, oh, go ahead.
Coaches are going to hate me for saying this, okay? but you can shop around. There's a lot of coaches out there nowadays.
Yeah,
and
I agree.
You can just, talk to people and find somebody that resonates with you and work with them.
Right. It's totally about what is a fit and what's not, right? So if one coach resonates over another, and you feel it in your heart that it's a good fit, I mean, just go with it, But yeah, and the thing is that, every single person that I know who is a love coach who is offering free sessions, they really just want to help you. They really just want to help you. And if you decide to work with them, great. If not, you've just helped another, person, which is so rewarding. That's what I have to say on that too. So I guess we're around our 30 minutes now, so we'll wrap up. And I just wanted to offer you the opportunity to share a little bit about your free gift. People, check out the link.
Yeah. So if you're really struggling to figure out what's going on with you, I also, what I have is a quiz, right? And you can take that quiz and it'll help you kind of determine what your biggest obstacle is to getting into the relationship that you want to get into, and just give you some free advice on, what to do from there. I actually built this quiz around some of my coaching consultations that I've done, and I've kind of determined that there's just a few different barriers that really stop women from, attracting the man and the relationship that they want. And so if that's what you're struggling with, just go take my quiz, and I hope it helps you.
Give you some insight. Awesome. Well, thank you so much for joining us, everyone, and we'll see you on the next video. Bye.